Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, Song of the Ocean Blind. I'm Amethyst Lutari. This guy doesn't want us to leave. But we have to, mister. I feel bad for you, says McBean. But I have some errands to take care of, so I need to go to Cranka. Are you taking Una and Forte along? Don't worry, I'll be back by sunset. He didn't answer. Oh man, I'm in trouble now. Confidently, we stride forward. Monstre! Okay, I might have figured out the finishing move thing. I checked the beginning of a walkthrough. Not even revealing anything. So I think we can move that thing. Let me see. I mean, we've got full attacks here. We're gonna completely destroy this monkey. Oh, cool! You gotta move it over, the little bracket, whatever. That frame. Got it. Oh, nice. That's why I couldn't do it, because that's why I could only do it with Forte, because I didn't move it over. I didn't realize you could move that over. That's cool. I don't know why they changed it. And Una, level 2, nice. McBean is at level 3. Interesting. Oh, I'm so glad we know how to use it. That's a pretty cool feature. It's kind of like not completely intuitive, but that's okay. Figured it out. Alright, so now Jan can use his magic move. Magic move? Is that what I said? Finishing move. Here he goes. Whoa. Nice. Those are good finishing moves there. I wonder if there's anything else that's like kind of hidden like that. So, yeah, he's got that jump rush, which I was able to actually use, because the bracket was on him. I couldn't move it. Well, I could. I just didn't know I could. So he used Rock Crash. We haven't seen that yet, because he still has to get his power up. Una used Shining Arrow, and Jan used Charge Dog, hurling oneself at the enemy. Cool. I like it. Plus, it's back to where finishing moves, like, automatically kill a creature. Which I didn't like when the monsters in Tier Vermillion started getting harder. And it was just damaging them, not killing them. I mean, you gotta expect that, but it's kind of cool to see enemies get decimated again by finishing moves. Get that one. Go that one, and you can bite this one. Missed. Didn't miss. Thank you. Nice, another purify potion. You keep gathering these potions, I haven't had to use a single one yet. Maybe I'll have the dog steal something else. Or should I even bother? I don't know. Yeah, we're fighting plenty in battles. I have a feeling, I'm pretty sure, like, we're gonna have the ten, like, quantity limit. We can only stack up to 10 and doesn't let us get any more of that particular item. So I have a feeling it's the same here. So either I wasn't really paying attention when I looked at the walkthrough, or a couple episodes ago when I just googled the info. Either I wasn't paying attention, or they didn't specifically mention that bracket, that frame around the character's portrait in battle. That I had to move that thing. I know, I keep repeating myself. It's just cool, I'm glad I figured it out. Forte going first. This moves. I don't know if you have any other reason to move it. Like, is there any reason to move it other than for a finishing move? Was it just there for that? Another purify potion. We're doing fine now. I think it would be a waste to heal somebody. I'm not sure how much the enemy surprises you. Ah! I don't like those kind of surprises. Well, that's a new thing too. I don't remember that happening in the other two games. Alright, we have our pick of monkeys. I'll have him go for that one and use his finishing move. She can hit that one. Bane can hit this one, and Jan can hit this one. I train with the sword too. Awesome. Kind of a waste to use Jan's or Una's finishing move now. This thing's already damaged. Another purify potion. How many of these do we have? Eight of them, wow. And I think I bought one or two of them. Oh, what a waste. yeah. Jan, heal self. Leave the other two for now. Monkey! Yeah. Shining arrow! Oh, nice! Got both of them. She should get extra experience for that, but, you know, there's not much to divvy up as it is. Oh, sorry about that. What happened there? Finishing move on Armadillon. Yeah, he interrupts people's attacks, even our own attacks. Oh, I meant to hit the Armadillon. I messed that up. Ah, man, I made it harder on us. It's more of a delay before the characters start running up and attacking. I noticed that. There's this little, like, 1 or 2 second pause. And it's not that noticeable, but when you got 4 people going and you have to wait, like, okay, move, you can notice it a little bit more. It's not a big deal, though. Is this chest reloaded? No. Okay. Whoever was hired to go around and reload the chests, you failed. Burrell says, "Hi, Mr. McMean. Long time no see." "Hey, Burrell. Sill? It's been a while. You working hard as usual?" Sill says, "Thanks to good dice of Rakos Palma. That motivates us to work hard." Una says, "What you just said will make the people in Rakos Palma happy." I think there's... like... is there a chest down here? I forget. Oh. McBean says, "What do you say? Up to rehearsing a little?" Sure, I guess. Sun through trees? McBean with his hand harp. You got the walking dog there. That's just a place for them to practice. Huh? McBean says, "We arrived at Cranka." "Okay, Mr. Obvious." McBean opens the magic map. Ruth Road is Rakos Palma. Okay. Chituna Road. Pinzo. Oh, that's Pinzo they keep talking about. That's where this, recital. It's either recitals or concerts or both. Sunbarl Road and Fargo? Fargot? Trim? Oh, we can look at all this crap, but let's not do all that now. "This map is too vague to figure out," says Forte. "Indeed," Una says. "We can't tell where in the village it is from looking at this." McBean says, "But one thing for sure is that it is here." "No, we haven't determined that. We're trying to determine that, McBean. First, let's ask around." "Hey, you! Hey, you! Yo, Mr. McBean! Hey, long time no see. You always look good, Mr. McBean. My mentality and physical strength are just as good as any young man." Seha says, by the way, Forte, I heard that you entered the Pinsel recital. Yeah, recital. I'm looking forward to it. Thanks. Okay. There's an old lady up here. Yeah. McBain says, hey, old friend. Long time no see.
What?
Long time no see, old friend.
I heard you.
Sorry. Is it true that the water through the waterway is contaminated with poison?
Yes.
Do you think it means there's something down underground here in Cranka?
What?
Anything underground?
I could hear you. There used to be natural water running through the underground, but it was buried a long time ago.
It looks like poisonous monsters have started dwelling there, so the underground waterway is going bad. That's why we built the waterway up on the ground.
I see. So there's also an underground waterway running.
He's always saying the most obvious things. Oh, brother.
Another old friend?
Hello, Mr. McBain. Long time no see.
You're as beautiful as ever, he says.
What's the occasion today?
Have you heard any rumor around here about a stone with musical scores or engraved on?
Are you looking for that?
A stone, huh? Never heard of it.
Have you heard of it?
Nope, says Okuru.
I must say that I have no idea. Sorry I couldn't help you.
No problem, says Forte. Thanks.
Mac, you look good.
You haven't changed a bit either.
You're with Mr. McBain today. Good for you.
That's a good thing. She approves.
Pupura approves! Yay!
Oh, Barepa, she's the one we needed to talk to, and I would have talked to her last. Oh, hi, Mr. McBain.
Hello.
I work on a weaving machine by myself while my parents are rinsing fabrics at the riverbank. I've been bored without anyone to keep me company.
Can I ask you something, says Forte?
Yes, of course. What's your question?
McBain says, have you heard of or seen a stone with staff notation engraved on it around here?
Let me think.
Never heard of it.
Really?
How long ago was it, she says.
Recently?
Well, it could have been nearly 50 years.
Then I'm the wrong person to ask since I'm too young.
Well, it's said that the underground waterway was buried when they built the waterway and water mills in Cranka. So it must have been in the underground waterway.
That could be a good lead, Grandpa.
You're right, McBain says. And do you know anyone who might know details about the construction back then?
I'm pretty sure that I've heard Mr. Hester's dad was in charge of the construction back then.
But he's dead. Hester may have heard something about it, though.
Una says, thank you, Barepa.
Don't mention it.
Alright, another down here.
Anyway, Mr. McBain, why don't you play something for us on the stage? I would love to be intoxicated with your music after a long interval.
I don't know. We just played something.
Let's play one song.
No.
I don't feel like it now, Forte says.
We can't get down from here.
The watermill is like a part of my family. If I look after it once in a while, it keeps spinning cheerfully. Your family spins around? Just for the record, my eyes spin well too. I remember him saying that. Oh, hi, Mr. McBean. It's been a long time. How's it going? You two have cute companies today. Now you're in Cranka, please go visit my husband. He's working in the Watergate cabin in the north. He would love to talk about fishing with you. Oh, maybe that's who we have to talk to about this... the stone. Cute companies. Oh, this girl. Look, there goes old Mac, Forte and Una. Hello, Gina, Forte says. Don't call me old, please. Una says, I don't want you to address me like that. Why did she say... She said, and Una. You don't like your name, or you don't like being said last? I think she said her name last. Forte, how's your trumpet coming? Are you practicing a lot? Why don't you play it for me a little? No. I don't know. I'm not very good at trumpet. McBean says, why don't you play the cithara instead? Good idea, says Una. You're quite a cithara player, Forte. Okay, I'll play the cithara for you, Gina. The only thing bad thing about these little parts is that we can't skip them. We have to just sit here and wait. Unless there's some secret button combination to do it. Forte, you're very good. Forte, thank you for playing for me. To show my appreciation, I'll give you my treasure. Forte receives dotted ribbon. Thank you, Gina. Don't mention it. You mean... Oh. Did she not say don't mention it? You mean don't mention it, right, says Una? Oh, no. Well, Una didn't protest this time. I still don't know why she does. Alright, did we visit everybody? I think we did. Place seemed bigger the first time we came here. Oh, we didn't talk to these people. Oh, yeah, someone important there. It's been a long time, Mr. McBean. You're Forte's teacher, right? Yeah, I'm teaching him little by little. His skill isn't yet refined, but he's promising. As long as you're the teacher, he'll do good. Forte, I'm looking forward to the recital. Good luck. I'm a big fan of yours. I'll cheer for you. Thanks. I'll try my best. I'm here for him. I'm there for him, too, Una mumbles. Alright, before we check with this person, let me just go look over here. That's the way of the water cabin. Alright, I think that's the only person we haven't talked to.
Hester.
Yeah. Yeah, Grandpa McBean. Can I ask you something?
What is it, out of the blue, Hester says. Have you heard of or seen a stone with staff notation engraved on it around here? If you know whether that kind of rumor had spread when they were building the waterway in Cranka, please tell me.
Oh yeah, when they destroyed the underground waterway, right? My late father told me.
That must be it, says Forte.
I don't know if that's what you're looking for, though.
If I remember correct, he was saying something about a crest-looking slate deep inside the underground waterway.
Oh yeah? And? McBean says.
My dad didn't know why such a thing had been placed there, so he left it there.
Una says, then it should still be there.
Probably, yeah.
But didn't they bury the underground waterway?
Grandpa, are you thinking about digging it up?
Hester says, I think they just buried those areas which were necessary for the foundation of the construction. So most parts of the underground waterway should still be there.
As long as you get in, I have a feeling that you can get there. You can ask Dorso for more details.
He's the Watergate keeper. He was a leader among the young workers during the construction. He should know more.
McBean says, oh, I owe you one, Hester.
Smack.
I thought he smacked him. McBean gave Hester a kiss on his cheek.
Yuck, Hester says.
Don't kiss me, Grandpa McBean. It's yucky.
Ask Dorso, the Watergate keeper, for further details.
Thanks a lot.
All right, let's go. To the waterway. It is this way. Watergate cabin. New area. For us, anyway. I just paused because I don't like when I can't see what's on the map. On the overland because of that sign. Oh, this goes all the way back. We can come in from this way too. Oh. I didn't realize we could take either way up. Oh, a chest. Another purify potion. Awesome. This guy just leaves chests around. They can ignore you and look at this fish.
Hmm, what a splendid size, McBean says.
It pulled pretty hard, didn't it?
Dorso says, kind of, but this is still a smaller one around here.
Bragger.
Hehe.
Before I talk to him, let me just go walk on the edge of this, whatever this is, this pier or whatever? Oh.
Okay.
Hey, Mr. McBean, what can I do for you?
Hester told me about you. Can you tell me what you know about the underground waterway of Cranka?
Why do you want to know about such an old story?
Una says, he said his father should have told you in detail about that time.
Ha ha ha, ask me about anything.
McBean says, did you see a slate deep inside the underground waterway on which something like a crest was carved?
Yeah, I did.
It was carved on the very furthest wall.
Do you remember what it looked like?
It was in scribbled letters like this.
Dorso drew with his finger in the air.
It's a crest of Leon, McBean says.
Really? Is that what it is?
I heard that the underground waterway was buried when they built the waterway on the ground, but the area around it still remained.
I think it's left as it was.
We just filled up the area where we were to build a waterway on the ground.
I believe you can sneak in the underground from the side of the waterway.
Really? Says McBean.
Hey, says Dorso. I don't know what you're up to, but I hope you aren't thinking about going into the underground waterway. I bet the place is now a den of poisonous monsters. Besides, in order to go in there, you have to close the water gate and stop the water mill. You need to obtain permission from Elder.
Or the Elder? Okay. Bane says, then as long as we obtain permission from Elder Scold, you'll close the water gate and draw water, right? All right, wait right here. He's an assertive old man. I'm not even a match, says Dorso. Oh, this whole thing again. I was just wanting to see if he would say anything different. Running back to town. Well, it's not far. Whoops. Is, like, everyone gone or something? McBane says, how did you get this color? This is the result of poison from the underground waterway that we were talking about, says Forte. Una says, at any rate, this is terrible. Is it always this bad? McBane says. Forte says, I'm not sure. I hear that it's leaking once in a while. McBane says, well, it's not the time to look for a resonance stone. Anyway, let's go see Scold first. Should we talk to this old lady again about the poisoning?
What is this? Poison keeps coming out today. My laundry will be stained. Oops-a-daisy.
Oops-a-daisy, huh? That kid that was running around here is not here. Oh, here he is. This doesn't look good. This is my first time to see poison spread so widely. If we leave it, poison will keep spreading through the waterway. Well, that's not good.
Did you find what you're looking for? What? The waterway is contaminated with poison? That's awful.
Poison? Oh my goodness.
The poison has started flowing out as we expected. We knew this would happen someday.
What an awful color. It's a lot different from usual. I'd better go counsel with Elder Scold.
You'll just stand there looking at it anyway.
I know such things. I think there's nothing over here. Let's see. Forte, Mr. McBane, is it true the waterway has been contaminated with poison? That's bad news. I wonder if we have to shut off the waterway. Oh. No, I didn't mean to go here. Filled with poison and you want to play music. You old fox. Okay, we got the merchant here. They're not going to say anything about it. Scold, says McBean. Oh, I didn't realize we ran into him here.
Oh, Mac, good to see you.
I've heard about this, but I didn't imagine it was this bad. Don't be such a stranger. I would have investigated if you had told me.
To tell you the truth, only now the poison leaked, only once in a while. Or until now, I mean. Besides, it stopped right away.
Anyhow, we need to close the water gate and drain the water.
Right, let's do that.
Oh, so we got a good reason. Everyone's got a good reason to close it now. I'll use this opportunity to go underground of Cranka and check what's going on there. You don't have any objection as the Elder of Cranka, do you?
No, but I feel like I've been forced to adjust myself to your pace.
It's just your imagination. So, I'll tell Dorso, the water gatekeeper, that I have your permission. Is it okay?
Yeah, go right ahead.
Good. Let's go, Forte, Una.
I almost forgot. If you're gonna go underground, you better prepare an antidote. You should be able to buy some at the tool shop.
You mean like...
this thing, these things? People say that poison has been spreading more and more. Of course you can stop the water mill, because if we leave it like that, I won't be able to work anymore. Don't hesitate to tell my husband if he can be of your help. He is the water gatekeeper to help you.
That was a very awkward couple sentences there.
What's happening to our water? What's going on?
Pure hell. Hellfire and doom. That's what's going on.
Look what they say if we go this way.
The magic map indicates we should be able to find a resonance stone somewhere in this village.
What is that way? Oh, Pinzel and Fargo, right? Are you selling any new weapons or anything? Oh! McBain can't use the auto shield?
Dull Knight 1.
Okay, I'm gonna get... oh, let's do the exchange. Because we don't have any... this. I'm gonna buy two of the Restore Snuff. And then two of the Lackety Paste. I might have one, but... why not? I didn't feel like going back to see if we actually have one. But now I can. We had one, so now we have three. And the Restore Snuff, we didn't have any. Oh, I talked to him.
I heard that you and Grandpa Scold came to the idea of going down into the underground waterway. Be extra careful, okay?
Mac, are you going to go check the underground waterway? Unless we do something about it, we'll lose the business. We're counting on you.
Are you going down there? Unless someone does something about this, we won't be able to use water here in Cranka. I'll do anything to help you, so hang in there.
There's nothing you can do. Nothing.
Going to underground waterway? Be careful.
What should we do? We can't get anything done unless we do something about it. McBain says, I've just got done discussing it with Scold. Forte says, we came to the conclusion that it's best to shut the water off and check out the underground waterway. To do so, we'll have to stop the water mill for a while if it's okay with you.
Of course. Thank you for doing that for us. But please be careful. The rumor has it that there are poisonous monsters swarming in the underground waterway.
Yeah, he said that before.
Oh my goodness, look at all my laundry soaked with poison.
You can fight monsters with that. As soon as they hit your clothes, they'll get poisoned. And you'll probably both die at the same time. I just talked to her, yeah. There was some kid around here, right? Did I talk to them after this? Is this where Mac was hanging out? I'm not sure. No, he was hanging out where the little girl is. Close the water gate? McBain says, yeah, we decided to check the cause, since we would be in the underground waterway. Forte says, Grandpa, isn't finding the cause of the poison the first priority? Hester says, in that case... He's obsessed with it, that's what it is. What? Are you going down the underground waterway? I don't mind stopping the watermill, of course. But Forte, be careful. Oh, the rest of us can just die? Only Forte has to be careful? Alright. Alright, just outside the cabin. We'll be telling him next episode to shut it all down. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.